What is up, YouTube? Lou Boyer coming to you from my hotel room here in Singapore. Kind of a cool room, got a good view. The only problem is I can't go outside, and that is because of this. So basically what it is, I don't know how well you guys are gonna be able to actually read it, but it's a basically stay-at-home notice for flight crews. And yeah, if you leave your room, it's 6 months in jail or a $10,000 fine, or maybe both. Anyway, that aside, even though I can't walk out that door, I'm still gonna make a kick-ass video for you guys. And I'm gonna do that by going through these. So these are my external hard drives. I have, I think, 6 terabytes of information on these. And yeah, what I'm gonna do is share every snake species I have ever found here in Singapore. And I think that's 20 different snake species. So, you know, it's gonna probably be a pain in the ass to find it all and edit it all, but I think the result will be pretty cool. So yeah, let's start off with some of the most common snakes, the whip snakes. So there are 3 species of whip snake in Singapore. I have only found 2, the big-eyed and the oriental. These snakes are most easily found at night, searching the edge of forests, where they're almost too green for their own good. This one is an oriental whip snake, the larger of the 2 species. While mildly venomous, the venom doesn't really have an effect on humans. This one's a big-eyed whip. You can see the eyes almost bulging out of its sockets. It's a bit smaller in size than the oriental whip and also mildly venomous. You can also find these snakes in the daytime once you know their habitat.
Yeah, that's a cool snake, isn't it?
If you happen to find one of these snakes on the ground, which would be rare, they'll want to climb the closest thing to them. So if you get close to them, stand still, they'll think you're a tree and treat you as such and start climbing. All right, so enough with the whip snakes. Let's move on to the pit vipers. There's the Wagler's pit viper and the shore pit viper. The shore pit viper inhabits the mangrove forest that surrounds Singapore. It's an extremely venomous snake that relies on camouflage to hide within its surroundings. While mainly brown in color, they vary slightly in pattern and coloration. Some have really red eyes. These snakes grow to be about 1 meter in length. It took me forever to find my first shore pit viper. Like most snakes, finding your first one is very difficult. Once I knew what I was looking for, finding shore pit vipers became quite easy. It's always fun showing these snakes to strangers that walk right by without even knowing they were there.
What's up, guys? You're on YouTube. Say hi.
Hi.
Hey, what's up, dude?
Next up is the Wagler's pit viper, one of my favorite snake species in Singapore.
Oh, look at that snake. Damn. That is a beautiful female Wagler's pit viper. That is stunning.
While the females are yellow and black, the males are actually green and much smaller. Here's a male in typical ambush position, waiting for a gecko or frog to come by. While the shore pit vipers are found along the coast, the Wagler's pit vipers are found in the central forest area. While their venom isn't as strong as the shore pit viper, it's still not a snake to be messed with. They will defend themselves if you get too close. What's interesting is the females actually start off green when they're born and transition to the yellow and black as they mature. This one is sort of in between, a subadult, and still has green on top. The Wagler's pit viper is one of my favorite snakes to find in Singapore. All right, as soon as this little crested lizard takes off, and these things are like little dinosaurs, they're super, super cool. Anyway, once he's out of the way, I'll share my next species, the paradise tree snake. All right, let's go, little guy.
All right, so here we go. Paradise tree snake, the flower phase. Yeah, more than I expected. This thing is awesome looking. Gonna put him down for some more natural pictures, but look at this guy.
All right, so the paradise tree snake is also known as a flying snake. It doesn't actually fly. It just glides away from predators, and I don't even know how often it actually does that. What I do know is it is one badass looking snake. It's got a cool pattern, great colors, and you know, being a tree snake, it's obviously a great climber. It is mildly venomous, but the venom doesn't affect humans.
Yeah, that's awesome to watch. Back at home in the treetops.
And next up, the reticulated python, the longest snake in the world.
Oh my God, look at the size of this thing. That is a big snake.
That snake was about 14 feet long and not even close to a full-grown adult. The second one I found up in a tree was quite a bit smaller.
Okay, so second snake of the night, reticulated python up in the tree. That is pretty sweet.
Whoa!
That is really sweet. It's actually coming this way, it looks like. It's coming down the branch towards us.
These snakes have striking patterns and really stand out. It's only once you see them in the water that you can fully appreciate the pattern and what it's for. They totally blend in once underwater. From the largest snake species in Singapore to two of the smallest, the reed snakes. This one, the dwarf reed snake, is tiny, as its name implies.
All right, so I'm gonna pick him up so you guys can fully appreciate his size or lack thereof. Be really careful because he's so small and delicate.
It's pretty drab in coloration and not too exciting to see. That said, I was excited to find my first one. In comparison, the pink-headed reed snake is relatively colorful and sort of mimics the venomous blue coral snake. It was the first snake I ever found in Singapore. Sticking with the small snake theme, this is a white-spotted slug snake.
So they're not a very big species of snake. This is probably just about full grown. Maybe a foot long.
What's interesting is this snake in Singapore has a bit of red or orangish on the neck, where here's one I found in Hong Kong that doesn't have any of that coloration. The white-spotted slug snake is the last species of snake I found in Singapore before COVID had us stuck in our hotel rooms.
There he goes.
Next up are the bronzebacks, which are commonly found sleeping on trees at night. I believe there are six different bronzeback species in Singapore. I have found four: the painted, the striped, the elegant, and the copsteens. I'll start off with the most drab and the most common to find, the painted. In fact, I don't even have that much video to share with you guys. They're relatively drab in coloration, being brown. They like to bite and they like to musk. So I usually just leave them alone. Next up is the striped bronzeback. I don't see these quite as often as I see the painted bronzebacks. They also like to bite and they also musk. So I typically leave them where I find them as well. Next up, one of my favorites, the elegant bronzeback.
Okay, it's probably been about an hour total I've been walking. And there's another snake here. Looks like another bronzeback. Let's see, where is he? There he is. But this one actually might be an elegant bronzeback. I can't tell. I'm going to try and get him down.
So here we go. I got him. Elegant bronzeback. And he is beautiful.
Look at that big eye. That's kind of the telltale sign of the elegant bronzeback. I don't know how well you can see the body. It's just awesome looking, isn't it?
Next up is the copsteens bronzeback, a beautiful snake.
Okay, so here's the copsteens. You're really gonna just see his head mainly because I've gotta hold his tail for now. If I don't hold his tail, he will be gone in no time.
When they get disturbed or agitated, they flare up and you can see all the different colors between the scales. Like the other two, they like to bite and would rather be left alone, like most snakes.
All right, so there we go. He's back in the tree there, and yeah, what an awesome snake, huh? I didn't want to stress him too much. I didn't hold him for too long. I just wanted to get some video, but yeah, I might take a little video as he goes higher up, but yeah, awesome find. Very, very cool.
Next up are the coral snakes, two of my favorite snake species in Singapore. I'll start with the smaller of the two, the Malayan banded coral snake. And while it's striped on top, there is a reason it's called banded. If you're able to actually look at the belly of this snake, you can see the banding. That said, it is highly venomous, and I don't recommend picking one up. Oh, and being so small in size, they can hide just about anywhere. This snake, the blue coral snake, is a large coral snake, getting to about 1.5 meters in length. It actually has the longest venom glands of any snake in the world. If you've seen this snake on TV, odds are I took the shots.
But the most feared in the jungle is the elusive blue Malaysian coral snake, brightly colored but extremely venomous. It's known as the 100-step snake for the distance its bite victims travel before dying.
While they're extremely venomous, they're incredibly docile. The striking colors, the electric blue sides, the red head, the red tail, it's just an awesome snake. It's one of my favorite snakes to find. From the electric blue colors of the blue coral snake to the drab and dreary looking dog-faced water snake. It's one of the most common snakes in Singapore. If you haven't found one yet, you just haven't looked hard enough. Like a lot of snakes, once you find your first one, finding the rest is easy. These inhabit the mangroves surrounding Singapore. They're active at night, hunting for fish. While they're occasionally found on land, they spend most of their time in the water. Next up, another snake that likes the water, the mangrove cat snake. While this striking looking snake is found near water, it doesn't spend a lot of time actually in water. It spends a lot of time in trees that overhang the water. That's where it sleeps in the daytime. I typically find it at night though, on the crawl in search of a meal.
Got a pretty good sized head for its body. And I love the way the black transitions down the face. Almost looks like teeth hanging out there.
The mangrove cat snake, otherwise known as the golden ringed cat snake, is mildly venomous and can give you a decent bite if it manages to hold on. They are excellent swimmers and are fun to watch swimming at night. The next snake is the spotted keelback.
So a really cool snake. He's about a meter long probably. You can see him breathing. We got him on the ground here. And he's pretty mellow.
What's interesting is there are actually two different color morphs of this snake, and it's just the neck basically. This one, as you can see, is yellow, while most are white. They are rather quick snakes and are usually gone in a flash. Next up is this white-bellied rat snake. While this is just a juvenile, these snakes get to well over 2 meters in size.
That is just a cool snake. And I say that about all the snakes I know, but yeah, look at the tongue on that. It's just glowing at night.
Okay, what's really interesting is that every snake I've shown so far is a potential food source for the next snake. That's right, you guessed it, the king cobra. And it truly is a king among snakes. Not only does it eat and consume other snakes, it's also the longest venomous snake in the world. The one I found here in Singapore was a subadult at approximately 3 meters in length. I'm going to leave you with a parting shot here of this king crossing the road. Now this road was approximately 3 meters wide, so you get a full appreciation of how big this snake is.
Oh, this is going to be too cool.
Anyways, after crossing the road, he took off into the water and went about his day. All right, well, that is going to do it for this video, guys. It has taken me 2 days. 2 days to edit that whole thing together. I hope you like it. Leave a comment if you do. You know, I know it's not my normal video by, you know, going out and finding things, but, you know, it's kind of the world we're living in right now. I'll probably do, my wife wants me to do a room tour just to kind of show this room because it's a little bit unique. So I'll probably put that in at the very end. But as always, guys, thanks for watching. Subscribe if you want to, and we'll see you. All right, so if you've seen my channel before, you know I'm an airline pilot. I work for a Japanese airline, and I stay in a ton of hotel rooms. But this is sort of the designated COVID hotel in Singapore we're staying at right now. You know, it's a little unique in the fact here, I'll just kind of walk around. It's a little bit messy too, but yeah, bed there. The biggie is this kind of a strange looking wall with flowers on it, and you can see through its glass there, and there is a bathtub in there and a shower and everything. And I'll just walk over here. It's gonna probably get a bit echoey, but yeah, you know, bathtub where you can look out through these like large flowers. It's different, you know. I don't know, like, there's a hotel across the way. Now, can they see in and see you while you take a bath? I don't know, maybe. I will say, with my camcorder looking across, and this thing has quite a zoom on it, their baths are right up against the window. Like, right up against the window. And, you know, I'm not gonna spy on people or anything, but that's kind of a strange design if you ask me. Anyway, yeah, that's it. Hotel here at the airport. You can see the tower there. It is relatively quiet though, considering, you know, it's right at the airport. And yeah, that's my room.